Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare.
Hare Krishna, thank you for coming to celebrate Gaur Purnima by glorifying Lord Chaitanya. If some of you are very new, I won't apologize. This is we are going to discuss some devotional topics. So this is a nice verse I want you to repeat after me. This is from Adi Lila of Chaitanya Charitamrita, second chapter, text number 117. So by today and tomorrow, by chanting this verse, you should be able to remember, memorize this simple verse. So you can repeat after me. सिद्धांता बोलिया चित्ते ना कर आलस बोलिया चित्ते या होइते कृष्ण लागे सुदृढ़ मानस सिद्धांता बोलिया चित्ते ना कर आलस या होइते कृष्ण लागे सुदृढ़ मानस सिद्धांता बोलिया चित्ते ना करो आलस या होइते कृष्ण लागे सुदृढ़ मानस Krishnadas Kaviraj Goswami is the author of Chaitanya Charitamrita. He has composed this verse where he says, Siddhanta. Siddhanta means philosophy. Philosophy hota na? Discussion. Boliya chitte. Discussion on philosophy for the consciousness is very important. Siddhanta boliya chitte na karo alas. This you understand. He is saying don't be lazy to understand philosophy. We generally want to hear stories, jokes, shayari, motivational speech. But are we interested to discuss philosophy? Mostly no. Because we think mere life se connected hi nahi. Nahi? But what is Kaviraj Goswami saying? Siddhanta boliya chitte na karo alas. You can repeat.
Siddhanta boliya chitte na karo alas.
Why is he saying don't be lazy? What will happen if you are not lazy? What is the meaning of don't be lazy in understanding philosophy? It means you are very sincere and attentive to understand. So what will happen? Second line reveals that. Iya hoite कृष्ण लागे सुदृढ़ मानस होइते कृष्ण लागे या होइते कृष्ण लागे कृष्णा विल बिकम फिक्स्ड इन दैट कॉन्शियसनेस वेर यू आर ट्राइंग टू अंडरस्टैंड फिलोसफी एंड देन व्हाट विल हैपन सुदृढ़ मानस योर माइंड विल बिकम स्ट्रांग सो इफ यू अंडरस्टैंड फिलोसफी टू थिंग्स विल हैपन फर्स्ट व्हाट What will happen if you understand philosophy of Krishna consciousness? I told nobody. Sorry. You will be touched with Krishna. Okay. We were saying something. Krishna will be fixed in the mind. And second? Mind will be strong. These are the two advantages. या होइते कृष्ण लागे कृष्णा विल बिकम फिक्स्ड इन द माइंड सुदृढ़ मानस एंड द माइंड विल बिकम स्ट्रांग इज इट क्लियर अ सिंसियर स्टूडेंट शुड नॉट निग्लेक्ट द डिस्कशन ऑफ सच कंक्लूजन्स कंसिडरिंग देम कॉन्ट्रोवर्सियल फॉर सच डिस्कशंस स्ट्रेंथन द माइंड दस वन्स माइंड बिकम्स अटैच टू श्री कृष्णा प्लीज रिमेंबर दिस इवन इफ यू डोंट रिमेंबर द श्लोका रिमेंबर वॉट ट्रांसलेशन तो याद रखना चाहिए आप वंस मोर वी विल चैंट ओके Siddhanta boliya chitte na kar alas.
Siddhanta boliya chitte na kar alas.
Ya hoite Krishna lage sudrida manas.
Ya hoite Krishna lage sudrida manas.
So there are many people who are not interested in philosophy. So let's see what Prabhupada says. There are many students who, in spite of reading the Bhagavad Gita, misunderstand Krishna because of imperfect knowledge and conclude him to be an ordinary historical personality. This one must not do. One should be particularly careful to understand the truth about Krishna. If because of laziness one does not come to know Krishna conclusively, one will be misguided about the cult of devotion like those who declare themselves advanced devotees and imitate the transcendental symptoms sometimes observed in liberated souls. Although the use of thoughts and arguments is the most suitable process for inducing an uninitiated person to become a devotee, neophytes in devotional service must always alertly understand Krishna through the vision of the revealed scriptures, the bona fide devotee and the spiritual master. Unless one hears about Sri Krishna from such authorities, one cannot make advancement in devotion to Sri Krishna. The revealed scriptures mention 9 means of attaining devotional service, of which the first and foremost is hearing from authority. The seed of devotion cannot sprout unless watered by the presence of hearing and chanting. One should submissively receive the transcendental messages from spiritually advanced sources and chant the very same messages for one's own benefit as well as the benefit of one's audience. When Brahma described the situation of pure devotees freed from the culture of empty philosophy and fruitive actions, he recommended the process of hearing from persons who are on the path of devotion. Following in the footsteps of such liberated souls who are able to vibrate real transcendental sound can lead one to the highest stage of devotion, and thus one can become a Mahabhagavat. From the teachings of Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu to Sanatana Goswami, Madhya Lila 2265, we learn Shastra Yukte Shunni Purna Drida Shraddha Yanra Uttam Adhikari Se Tare Samsara. A person who is expert in understanding the conclusion of the revealed scriptures and who fully understands to the cause of the Lord is actually able to deliver others from the clutches of material existence. Shri Rupa Goswami in his Upadeshamrita 3 advises that to make rapid advancement in the cult of devotional service, one should be very active and should persevere in executing the duties specified in the revealed scriptures and confirmed by the spiritual master. Accepting the path of liberated souls and association of pure devotees enriches such activities. Imitation devotees who wish to advertise themselves as elevated Vaishnavas and who therefore imitate the previous acharyas but do not follow them in principle are condemned in the verse of Srimad Bhagavatam 2.3.24 as stone-hearted. Sri Vishwanath Chakravarti Thakur has commented on their stone-hearted condition as follows. Bhairashru kulakayo shator api yat dridayam na vikriyeta tadashmasaram iti kanishta adhikarinam eva ashru kulakadi matvepi ashmasara hridayatya Ninda Aisha, those who shed tears by practice but whose hearts have not changed are to be known as stone-hearted devotees of the lowest grade. Their imitation crying induced by artificial practice is always condemned. The desired change of heart referred to above is visible in the reluctance to do anything not congenial to the devotional way. To create such a change of heart, conclusive discussion about Sri Krishna and his potencies is absolutely necessary. False devotees may think that simply shedding tears will lead one to the transcendental plane even if one has not had a factual change in heart, but such a practice is useless if there is no transcendental realization. False devotees lacking the conclusion of transcendental knowledge think that artificially shedding tears will deliver them. Similarly, other false devotees think that studying books of the previous acharyas is unadvisable, like studying dry empiric philosophies. But Srila Jiva Goswami, following the previous acharyas, has inculcated the conclusions of the scriptures in the 6th thesis called the Shat Sandarbhas. False devotees who have very little knowledge of such conclusions fail to achieve pure devotion for want of zeal in accepting the favorable directions for devotional service given by self-realized devotees. Such false devotees are like impersonalists who also consider devotional service no better than ordinary fruitive actions. It's a very long purport, and very emphatically Prabhupada says that we have to ultimately discuss about Krishna directly. And if you are lazy for that, 2 things will not happen. Krishna will not be in the heart and mind will not be strong. Everybody, you know, in this world is talking about mind. I'm getting so many invitations now to write articles for so many newspapers on mind. I want to tell them, just chant Hare Krishna. Allow Krishna to enter the mind. Simple. Because Prabhupada said, this is the Prabhupada would say this statement, you know, blacksmith solution and goldsmith solution, you know. Sau sunar ki ek lohar ki. Suna hai? Wo sunar goldsmith tap 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 karta 100 baar. ब्लैकस्मिथ क्या करता है, एक पिट में ढा. तो प्रभुपाद सेड कृष्णा कॉन्शियसनेस, रिमेंबरिंग कृष्णा, चैंटिंग कृष्णा नेम इज द ब्लैकस्मिथ सॉल्यूशन फॉर द माइंड. दैट्स व्हाई कविराज गोस्वामी सिंह सिद्धांत बोलिया चित्ते ना करो आलस, या होइते कृष्ण लागे सुदृढ़ मानस. आपको याद करा के रहूंगा कल तक. Already 10 times you have chanted. But this is most important point. If we don't discuss about Krishna, our mind will not become strong. So we have to receive Krishna. So therefore, Gaur Purnima festival is an opportunity for us to open our hearts to receive Krishna. Because many times we have obligations. Just like in our office, you can't talk about Krishna. Many times as preachers also in many forums, we can't talk about Krishna. But we have to have a forum where we come together and glorify Krishna. You know, Mama Mana Mandire Raho Nishidin Krishna Murari Sri Krishna Murari. Bhaktivinoda Thakur is appealing in his prayer that Krishna, please come and stay in my mind. Please come and stay in my heart. Even as preachers, we have to indirectly preach many times, you know, like giving food through the behind the head, through the ear and then to the mouth. But directly you can eat. Similarly, in preaching, many times we have to indirectly give Krishna. But that's okay. But if we don't fill our heart with Krishna, then that indirect preaching will also not continue for after some time. And we can't transform hearts if we are not filled with Krishna. We may not tell about Krishna to others. That's another thing, because we have to be sensitive. But what about your own heart as a devotee? Are you filled with Krishna? So therefore, Lord Chaitanya's incarnation is, Lord Chaitanya's agenda is very clear. Krishna, 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 hey. You would chant this mantra. This is given in Chaitanya Charitamrita. Krishna, 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 Pahi Ma. Krishna, Krishna, Krishna. Keshava, Krishna Keshava, Raksha Ma. Ram Raghava, Ram Raghava, Ram Raghava, Raksha Ma. So, Lord Chaitanya would chant these mantras. Only, very clear, Krishna, Krishna, Krishna. Krishna ka naam lena. And if we don't understand this, then as Hare Krishna devotees, hum 20 saal nikala, 30 saal nikala, sab waste. Krishna ko ek Krishna ke paas connection nahi ho gaya, to sab waste ho gaya. Then as preachers, we are extremely dangerous. Muslimano mein bolte na, naya hakim khatrae jaan, naya mulla khatrae iman. Koi doctor achche se nahi kiya, naya naya hakim hai, to kya hoga? Naya hakim khatrae jaan, jaan ko khatrae. Naya mulla, matlab wo maulvi preacher achche se wo नया मौलवी या पुराना भी खतरा है ईमान. सॉरी फॉर दैट, दैट वाज स्पॉन्टेनियस. तो रिलीजन के लिए बहुत डेंजर है. नहीं, द पॉइंट आई एम सेइंग इज हेड, हेड और हार्ट. फैनेटिक्स, सी वी हैव लॉट ऑफ फैनेटिक्स. सो अल्टीमेटली द क्वेश्चन इज द हार्ट गेटिंग ट्रांसफॉर्म. एंड द हार्ट इज ट्रांसफॉर्म टू द प्रोसेस ऑफ प्यूरिफिकेशन, साधना भक्ति, वेयर वी एक्चुअली चैंट. We actually hear for hours and systematically we connect to Krishna, and that's how the soul gets purified. All the dirt goes away. Otherwise, jo dirt hai, gandagi hai soul ke upar, wo jayega nahi. So, we have to ensure that we are doing something as purification. Like, aap office jate ho, school, college ka padhai karte ho, kabhi kabhi ichha nahi bhi hota karte ho na. उसको प्यूरिफिकेशन बोलते हैं. व्हेन यू डोंट लाइक बट यू डू, इट्स ऑस्टेरिटी, तपस्या. भक्ति में कोई तपस्या करते हैं? नहीं. क्लास तो एंटरटेनमेंट होना चाहिए. नहीं, क्लास शुड ऑल्सो बी हर्ड लाइक प्यूरिफिकेशन. समटाइम वी डोंट अंडरस्टैंड, और समटाइम इट्स ड्राई, समटाइम इट्स फिलोसफी. वी ओनली थिंक मेरे को, मेरे लिए रिलेवेंट नहीं है. वी विल नेवर, इट्स नॉट प्यूरिफिकेशन. इफ वी आर ओनली लुकिंग फॉर इंस्पिरेशन, मोटिवेशन, देन वी आर लुकिंग फॉर अ किक. We are looking for a क्या बोलते हैं, एक टेस्ट. And then we'll need jokes, we will need music, we will need shayari. And this is not nourishing, this is not purifying. And problem is, you don't want to go through hard work. 16 rounds hard work. We don't want to go through 3-4 hour of class. Imagine we give 4 hour class now, not in an AC room, but in the hot sun. It's crazy. Nahi hoga. Just 2 minute ka lecture do Prabhuji. Wo bhi kuch. Aajkal sab 2 minute ka lecture chalta hai. So it's like a drug. So our understanding in bhakti should be, we need purification and we need inspiration, both. But most important is purification. Because inspiration is not in our hand. Don't try to get inspired in bhakti. Because inspiration is a gift that Krishna gives. Sometimes people say, Prabhuji, today class was so practical. What a practical class you gave, Prabhuji. Thank you. So when a person says that, I immediately think, oh, this person was looking for some solution for some problem. He figured out something. You know, some sense of control, some sense of achievement. That's good. We feel good. But purification is different. You know, purification takes place when we have an attitude of quiet reception to sound. Purification happens when we have quiet reception to Krishna Katha. There is no glamour there. There is no loudness. There is no, you know, like, I don't like. Oh, any question. Sunday or Monday, you know, I will chant Hare Krishna, I will hear, I will wait patiently for Krishna. Today, tomorrow, day after, no masala, no jokes. The focus is on purification, not inspiration. Only then Krishna will reveal himself in the heart. Because inspiration and that motivation and that, you know, that energy, that enthusiasm, it's Krishna's gift. How Krishna reveals, we don't know. But purification is our attempt to show Krishna our sincerity. Krishna, see, I am sincerely hearing your class. Sincerely, I am studying scriptures. So, Gaur Lila, we will discuss today and tomorrow. I gave this introduction because I want you to receive Lord Chaitanya's pastime and philosophy without judgment, with an open mind. Just receive. Don't have judgments, because in the long run, I agree, we all need inspiration. But to be inspired, in the long run, we have to hear Krishna's voice in the heart. Only when we hear Krishna's voice in the heart, we will be inspired to do bhakti. And that Krishna's voice in the heart, to hear that, we need to trust. You know, we need to trust Krishna's voice. We need to hear first scriptures, because scriptures is Krishna coming in this material world. Bhagavatam, Bhagavad Gita. So when we hear scriptures without judgment, by that practice, we will be able to hear what? Krishna's voice. We can't say, Prabhuji, just give an inspiring class. I will just hear. I'll get motivated. No, that's not going to work. So basically, it's hard work. If you want to hear Krishna's voice, God's voice in your heart, you have to first hear God's voice outside. And God's voice outside is scriptures, Bhagavatam. Unfortunately, modern generation wants what? Fast. Everything fast, quick, entertainment, and anything long, slow, they get impatient. But if you see, Krishna is revealed by a slow process. Aram. Hear, chant, reflect. Because this study and hearing and chanting consistently is more important than inspirational intensity or something immediately we want. That is not sustainable. Pura phus ho jayega. So habits are more important than all these motivational videos, motivational speeches. Because habits are dal roti, they are the chapati, sabzi, they are the nourishment. Purification. Motivation is like having pizzas or chatpata, you know, bhel and all that, pasta. So what happens if you eat only those things, ice cream and pizzas every day? What will happen? Your taste buds get destroyed. Then you will not be able to relish food that is healthy for you, like moong dal, turiya sabzi, bopla. चपाती दाल राइस ये जरूरी है खाना, बीच बीच में थोड़ा वैरायटी के लिए यू ईट. बट दैट सिमिलरली हियरिंग भागवतम एंड गौर लीला चैतन्य चरितामृत कृष्ण कथा शुड बी अवर दाल रोटी मेन डायट. अनफॉर्चुनेटली दैट हैज बिकम रेयर एंड ऑल द चटपटा एंटरटेनमेंट इज बिकम एवरीडे फेयर. दैट्स नॉट, कृष्णा नहीं आता है उसमें बिकॉज वी आर डूइंग, वी आर बींग लेजी. व्हाट डिड कविराज गोस्वामी से आदि लीला सेकेंड चैप्टर टेक्स्ट नंबर 117 विच आई चैंटेड 10 टाइम्स. Okay, we'll try. You can try even if you don't know it. I'll help you. Try karo. Pehla line. Wait. Jor se bolenge. Siddhanta boliya chitte na karo alas. Second line. Hari bol. Iya hoite Krishna lage sudrida manas. So iya hoite Krishna. Krishna will come in the mind only if you are not lazy to hear about Krishna. And sudrida manas, the mind will become strong. So let us seek proper dal roti nourishing sabzi, not chatpata khana, hai na? So therefore scriptures don't give you kick, they are not nasha, they are nourishment. And iska bahut kam log hai iska demand. But Rishabhdev says to his sons in Bhagavatam 5th canto, तपो दिव्यम पुत्र का येन सत्वम शुद्धे दस्मात् ब्रह्म सौख्यम तनंतम. ह्यूमन लाइफ इज मेंट फॉर ऑस्टेरिटी, ह्यूमन लाइफ इज मेंट फॉर सिटिंग एंड हियरिंग अबाउट द लॉर्ड पेशेंटली इंट्रोस्पेक्टिवली अंडरस्टैंडिंग, नॉट लुकिंग फॉर थ्रिल्स एंड जोक्स. सो इज दैट क्लियर? दिस इज द इंट्रोडक्शन आई एम गिविंग. सॉरी फॉर अ लॉन्ग इंट्रोडक्शन. But before I speak, I'm going to speak a very important pastime, which is Lord Chaitanya, in Lord Chaitanya's pastime, this is the most powerful pastime. But for that, you have to be attentive. And I've never spoken this in Borivali in my last 16 years, I'm coming. Because I thought people will not be ready for it. But I said, aaj to de denge, aaj aur kal. Even if they're not ready, it's their problem. Because people are looking for inspiration. I'm saying, but purification is more important. Because you can't be inspired by Krishna. You can be purified. See, you can't be inspired by Raslila. Oh, Krishna is doing Raslila with gopis. I'm inspired. Krishna lifted Govardhan Hill. I'm inspired. No, you can't be inspired. Prabhupada called so many atheistic scientists rascals. I'm also inspired. No, you can't be inspired to imitate. You know, see, we hear Prabhupada's pastime, we hear Krishna's pastime so that the heart, which is dirty, gets cleansed. Clean hona chahiye na heart. Uske liye hum log sunte hain. Aur jo inspiration hai na, jo aap bol rahe ho, many times it is a mind getting thrill. Heart se nahi hai, wo deep inspiration nahi hai. Deep inspiration means you will want to commit yourself to Krishna. You will want to sacrifice, you will want to give to Krishna. But if it is simply what you are thinking it is inspiration, but you are actually wanting entertainment, then it is not deep. It is not inspiration. It is self-deception. You are cheating yourself. Because inspiration is very personal. Bahut personal hai. Aapko kaise inspire karte hai Bhagwan? Abhi dekho, ek hi ghar mein Anandan Prabhu is inspired to chant and his son is inspired to do duty worship. Kya Krishna ne dono ko alag ढंग से inspire kiya na? And the Mataji is there in that congregation. They are inspired to cook prasad. Inspiration is very personal. You can't legislate it. Inspiration is spontaneous. But purification is a scientific process. Our acharyas have given us, Srila Prabhupada has given us process of purification. You should do this. You should practice like this. He has not given us a process of inspiration. Is that clear? So with that mood, we will hear Lord Chaitanya's one very important pastime today. Is that okay? तो आपको नींद आएगा तो क्या करेंगे आप? खड़े हो जाने. डर शर्माने का नहीं, एसी भी है, सब अच्छा है. मत पूछ है गालिब की मंजिल कहाँ है, ये रास्ते हसीन है, तू भी यहाँ है. सो वेरी नाइस. डोंट आस्क अबाउट गॉड, पैक टू गॉड इट. अच्छा है, एसी है, सब पीसफुल. थोड़ा बीच में झपकी मारेंगे थोड़ा. इफ दैट इज अ मूड, इट्स गोइंग टू बी डिजास्ट्रस बिकॉज process of purification will work only when we are attentive. Kaviraj Goswami says, Kripa Sudha Sari Dhyasya Vishwam Aplavayantapi Nicha Gaiva Sadabhati Tam Chaitanyam Prabhum Bhaje. Lord Chaitanya's Kripa is Sudha. Sudha means nectar. Nectar in river. Kripa Sudha Sari Dhyasya. And this nectar river will drown the entire world. Vishwam Aplavayantapi. But this river flows, out of the river flow, does it flow up or down? Nicha Gaiva Sadabhati. It flows down. Tam Chaitanya Prabhum Bhaje. So I am down, waiting for Lord Chaitanya's mercy to fall on. So therefore, we have to be in the mood of receiving below with humility. And that is the process of purification. That's how we are going to hear Lord Chaitanya's pastime. And Prabhupada had this faith in purification. In fact, one of the first books Srila Prabhupada gave, from which I have taken for today and tomorrow's class, is a book called Teachings of Lord Chaitanya. And in the early 70s, every day morning classes in all ISKCON temples would be reading from this book, Teachings of Lord Chaitanya. It's pure philosophy. And from day one, Srila Prabhupada wanted his followers to hear about Lord Chaitanya, Gaur Lila. In the very initial days in New York in 1966, Prabhupada gave 3 months every day morning evening class on Lord Chaitanya, meeting Sanatana Goswami. So you can see that, and Lord Chaitanya, Prabhupada is very clear, Lord Chaitanya is not incarnation of Krishna. Who is he? He is the source of all incarnations. He is actually the Supreme Lord, he is Avatari. And therefore it's very important we hear about Lord Chaitanya. And Srila Prabhupada said, and scriptures say, which is the scripture recommended for Kali Yuga? Which is the scripture for Kali Yuga? Srimad Bhagavatam. Srimad Bhagavatam we'll understand only if we do two things. I taught this in the Bhakti Vaibhav class few weeks ago. Srimad Bhagavatam can be understood by two activities. One is reading Bhagavatam, and second, serving Bhagavat, person Bhagavat. Aplu bhul gaye, mujhe malum tha. Person Bhagavat you have to serve and you have to hear Bhagavat. And Chaitanya Mahaprabhu is the supreme person Bhagavat, because he is to always hear Bhagavatam. Sometimes he is to hear same pastime for 100 times. Matlab itna unko taste tha Bhagavatam. That's why if you see in the introduction of Srimad Bhagavatam, Prabhupada have written almost 50 pages only story pastime of Lord Chaitanya. Detailed. So therefore, if you are glorifying Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, we are doing two things. We are actually reading of Bhagavatam only, because he is person Bhagavat. And also we are serving person Bhagavat. We are serving him. We are glorifying him. Therefore, if you are hearing Lord Chaitanya, we are actually studying Srimad Bhagavat. And Chaitanya Mahaprabhu's philosophies and pastime will mesmerize the heart. And there will be purification also. There will be inspiration also. In fact, philosophy is very dry. You know that? Kaviraj Goswami says, you should hear philosophy, don't be lazy. But he also says, in the philosophy, if there is no Krishna, he says it is like dry oil cake. Have you ever eaten dry oil cake? Kabhi khaya? Maine to nahi khaya. But Maharaj, Radhana Swami Maharaj bolte hain class mein, he once wanted to try it. Why Kaviraj Goswami is saying it's dry oil cake? So he made that. He says dry oil cake is something which you keep chewing and chewing and chewing, no taste. Pura jaws ko exercise ho jata hai usse. So philosophy is like that. But if we add Krishna's pastimes, Lord Chaitanya's pastimes, then that philosophy becomes very sweet. Madhur Chaitanya Leela Samudra Gambhir Loke Na Bhuje Yehi Bhuje Bhakta Dhir. Madhur Chaitanya Leela. Lord Chaitanya's pastimes are madhur. Madhur means very sweet. But at the same time, remember this. Madhur Chaitanya Leela Samudra Gambhir. Samudra jaisa deep hai. Kya hai na? Combination. Generally, aap is dunya mein kuch bhi sunoge, entertaining, it is sweet, madhur sweet, but it will not have depth. Aur jo bahut deep discussion rahega, usme sweetness nahi rehta. But Chaitanya Mahaprabhu ka uniqueness dekhi. Madhur Chaitanya Leela Samudra Gambhir. And ordinary people cannot understand this. Loke na bhuje yehi bhuje bhakta dhir. Sober devotees only can understand. And they can understand only if they are sober and they are not lazy. What is that verse we memorized in the beginning of today's class? Who will try to lead the chant? Nobody? Siddha. Okay. Yes, Riya Mathil. Ah, first line bolo naam. Siddhanta boliya chitte. Siddhanta boliya chitte na karo alas. या होइते कृष्ण लागे सुदृढ़ मानस या होइते कृष्ण लागे सुदृढ़ मानस. What is the meaning? Anybody would like to tell the meaning of this shloka? No, not you. Strong. Hari bol. Got it. Don't be lazy. Na karo alas. Main. Unka. Theek hai? So if we hear like that, then we'll relish. And Chaitanya Mahaprabhu ka sab pastime jaise hi hai. Sweet bhi hai, deep philosophy bhi hai. Like, you know, even when Lord Chaitanya appeared as a small baby, Nimai, he would enchant everybody by making them chant Hare Krishna. Like the elderly ladies of Sachi Mata, they would come home and Nimai would be crying. And they would try many ways to pacify him, but they would not stop crying. And then suddenly one lady said, Hari, Krishna's name. And immediately, baby Nimai smiled. And then suddenly they all realized, oh, if you chant Krishna's name, he smiles. Then they all started chanting Hare Krishna. Then Nimai was also clapping. For they realized that the child is very attracted to holy name. And as he grew up, he would play with his friends. One day while playing, what he did with all his friends, he said, let us chant Krishna's name. So they all started chanting, playing, jumping on the mud, sand. They were all dirty. Some big elderly Brahmana pandits were going there. They were very sober people, very grave, Navadvi Brahmanas. So they saw, and Lord Chaitanya is very attractive, even as a small boy, little Nimai. So when they came near Lord Chaitanya, Nimai looked at them and said, please chant Hari. So they said, they were so mesmerized by this little boy, they said, Hari. And then the association of baby Nimai, little Nimai, all the learned Brahmanas started clapping, chanting, dancing, and they started jumping. And they became like children. Meanwhile, Sachi Mata is thinking, where is my little Nimai? I'm not finding him. So she came out of the house looking for her baby, for her child, for her boy. And she saw in the middle of the street, little Nimai is surrounded by all these big learned Pandit Brahmanas who are jumping, dancing. She was shocked because her son was filled with all mud, dirt. And she was shocked because these are very sober Brahmanas. And she got so angry with them. She came running. She grabbed her Nimai. She said, Nimai, you have become so dirty with all this mud. And all this is because of these Brahmanas. You stupid, silly behavior of yours. She started shouting at all these Brahmanas. You are supposed to be learned, sober, and you are spoiling my child by dancing, jumping like mad people. You have no culture. You have no shame. She chastised them left, right, center. And she lovingly hugged her baby, Nimai, and she took him home. And Nimai was smiling. And these Brahmanas are wondering what happened to them. They were bewildered. Arey, kya ho gaya apne ko? Hum kaise karne lage aisa sab? That is the mesmerizing effect of Lord Chaitanya. He just captured. They didn't know what hit them. This is Lord Chaitanya. So therefore, today, on this occasion of Gaur Purnima, upcoming Gaur Purnima festival, we'll discuss one of the most worshipable pastimes from Chaitanya Charitamrita, which is there in the Madhya Lila. 8th chapter. There are 313 verses. How many? And also I have taken from teachings of Lord Chaitanya. This is a pastime where you will find three things. You will find amazing poetry. You will find drama. And you will also find depth. Tino. Maja aega. But highest Siddhanta will be revealed. But to understand that Siddhanta, you should not be lazy. Yes, that means what? That is negative. Don't be lazy is negative. What you should be? Attentive, enthusiastic. And this highest Siddhanta of Gaudiya Vaishnava philosophy is revealed by God Himself. And before we discuss this philosophy and this pastime, let us sing Sachesuta Ashtakam, which is a very beautiful prayer glorifying Lord Chaitanya. Can you lead? You have the sheets. You can distribute. And after chanting this, you can chant once all the prayer. And then we will continue the pastime. So everybody understood so far what we discussed in the last 45 minutes? What is the main message of today's class so far? Huh? Okay, who will answer? What did I speak so far? Yes, Mataji. Be attentive. Don't be lazy. Thank you. Anything else? What are we? Don't look for short-term motivation. Look for? Yes. What is more important? Purification is more important. So we are going to hear and discuss as a part of our purification, as a part of our cleansing process. Is that okay? We'll chant. So this is a very beautiful prayer composed by Sarvam Bhattacharya. Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, with ordinary people, he would only discuss Bhagavad Gita and Vedanta philosophy whenever he would discuss. And he would also only do Kirtan with them. Kirtan, Bhagavad Gita and Vedanta philosophy. But there were few people with whom he would discuss very deep, esoteric rasa tattva. Swarup Damodar Goswami and Ramananda Raya. Every night they would sit in Jagannath Puri and they would discuss whole night very deep topics. So one of those confidential discussions we will discuss now. This is a very, very high topic. Your mind will be blown away by what you are going to hear now. So are you ready for it?
Yes.
Yes? Okay. But Chaitanya Mahaprabhu gives a disclaimer in the last chapter of Chaitanya Charitamrita. The end of the Chaitanya Charitamrita to Ramananda Raya and Swarup Damodar. He says that all these high topics is there. But for all of us, practically, what is the essence? Holy name, service, and prasad. Prasad, you haven't said, I am saying. So, this three is simple. If we have three in our life, in the last chapter, I'll just briefly give the disclaimer first so that when you feel a little bewildered, then you can come back to this statement of Lord Chaitanya. Harsha Prabhu kahen shuno swarup Rama Rai. Harsha Prabhu, with great joy, Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu said, Shuno, who? Swarup. Swarup means Swarup Damodar. And Rama Raya means Ramananda Raya. Harsha Prabhu, with great joy, Lord Chaitanya told them, Listen to me. I want to tell you something very important. What is that? Harsha Prabhu kahen shuno swarup Rama Raya. Nama sankirtana kalo parama upay. In Kali Yuga, the greatest upay is what? Nam sankirtan. What will happen if you do sankirtan like this? Like now, just now we sang. This is sankirtan, coming together and chanting. What will happen like this if you do this? This is worship of Krishna in Kali Yuga. Sankirtana yagya Krishna kalo aradhan. In the Kali Yuga, Krishna's worship is through sankirtan yagya. And if you are intelligent, what you will do? You will accept this. Sumedha. Sumedha means intelligent. Sankirtana yagya kalo Krishna aradhan seito sumedha paye Krishnera charan. If you want Krishna's feet, you want to get that shelter of Krishna's lotus feet, you will get if you take part in Sankirtana yagya. So this is the essence. But there is deeper things also involved within the holy name. In fact, if you chant sincerely, what will happen? Mahaprabhu tells Swarup Damodar Goswami that wherever there is Nam Sankirtan, three things will happen. Nama Sankirtana hoite sarva anartanash sarva shubhodaya Krishna premera ullas. He says, wherever Nam Sankirtan happens, Nama Sankirtana hoite sarva anartha nash, all the unwanted things in the heart, they will get destroyed. This is the power of the holy name. Sarva anartha. Anartha matlab jiska koi arth nahi hai, valueless. Nash. Nama Sankirtana hoite sarva anartha nash. Second, sarva shubhodaya Krishna. Auspiciousness. Shubh. Ghar ke baar aap lagate ho na, shubh chin. Swastik. Dalte ho? Wo Hitler ke log lagate the, swastik symbol. Before killing people. That swastik symbol. Or that auspiciousness, Om likhte hain, we do all that, we put kalash also. So many things we do. Shubh labh. All that we do for auspiciousness, right? But Sarva Shubhodaya Krishna, wherever there is Sankirtan, there will be auspiciousness. And what will happen? Sarva Shubhodaya Krishna. Third one, Premera Ullas. Love will awaken in the heart. Everybody is looking ultimately for love. And in all relationships, you are looking for love. And there is frustration because that love doesn't come. Because every human being in this world only expects love from the others. But this world is very place where everybody wants to take love from you. But you are hungry for love. And that hunger for love will be satisfied with Nam Sankirtan. But this is all Lord Chaitanya is saying in the last chapter. As conclusion of Chaitanya Charitamrita. And therefore, we are going to start from April one event in our Kandivilli preaching called Sankirtan Yagya. It's going to be not any time you can walk in and go anytime. It will be Yagya. You will have to do Sankalpa. Means 8 o'clock you come for the program. Breakfast will be served. Nice. Idli, vada, chutney, all that. And then around 8:30, 8:40 tak breakfast ho jayega sabka. 8:40 we will start Sankalpa. Sankalpa means we'll all stand with flowers and altar. Mein, so altar rahega. We'll offer flowers and we'll chant mantras, Vedic mantras. We'll chant Guru Parampara mantras and for 15 minutes we'll take Sankalpa. That abhi hum kya karenge? Sankirtan Yagya karenge. Just like when you do Yagya, you can't get up in the middle of the Yagya and go. So here we'll do Sankirtan Sankalpa karenge. Then from 8:45 or 9 o'clock, jab Sankalpa khatam ho jayega, 9 to 1, 4 hours non-stop we will do Kirtan. And the only time you are allowed to get up is for responding to nature's call. If you want to go to the bathroom, that's the only time you can get up. But 4 hours you have to sit there. Kirtan hoga bas. Beech beech mein Harinam ke upar thoda bolenge. And 1 o'clock, nice lunch will be served. Paneer, sabzi, kofta, roti. Advertise. So 1:30 you are free. This will be called Sankirtan Yagya. So if you are interested, you can give your name to Vedmurti Prabhu and Priyamanjari Mataji. Both of you, all of you know them, right? So, but you have to, what is the rule? You can't come at 9 o'clock, 10 o'clock. You have to come at what time? 8 for breakfast. And then go after lunch. Is that okay? And even if there are 5 people, we will do that. We are not interested in number. We are interested in, because Sankirtan ke liye 2 log kaafi hai. और हम मंदिर से लाएंगे, अगर नहीं डे आए तो हम मम्मी गा लेंगे. अभिषेक प्रभु है, महाप्रभु, दीनानाथ महाप्रभु प्रभु है ना, हम लोग सब अपना गा के कीर्तन करके निकाल लेंगे. इफ यू आर इंटरेस्टेड यू कम. व्हाट विल हैपन इफ यू टेक पार्ट इन द संकीर्तन? यू विल एक्सपीरियंस सर्व अनर्थनास, यू विल एक्सपीरियंस ऑस्पिशियसनेस इन योर लाइफ एंड यू विल एक्सपीरियंस लव. सो देयरफॉर this is there. And Lord Chaitanya, you would discuss very confidential things. This particular discussion I am talking about didn't happen in Jagannath Puri. It happened in a place called Vidyanagar in Kovur. Now, this is a small village in South India. In fact, if you go there today, you will find 2 Gaudiya Mutts also, small place. Bhaktivedanta Thakur Srila Prabhupada also went there. And it's actually far from Vrindavan and Mayapur. That's why many devotees don't go there so much. But Chaitanya Mahaprabhu and Ramananda Raya, they met there first time. And the discussion they had is explosive. The first time I heard this was in 1999 South India Yatra. I had just joined the ashram. And remember, you were there? How my long journey, that summer, hot summer we were going. People are hungry, nothing to eat. And then in that bank of Godavari, morning 11:30 or 12 o'clock, you were not there for that Yatra. It was one of the most austere Yatras. You must have heard about it. 11:30 started the class in that bank of Godavari, intense summer heat of South India. And everybody sitting. For next 3 hours, rapt attention, Maharaj spoke that pastime for 3 hours. And everybody is in that bank of the river. Hot summer. Khane ke liye bhi kuch nahi. Oh. Then 3 o'clock, 3:30 lunch hua. Intense tha. And Maharaj would repeatedly say, be attentive, don't sleep, he would say like that. And devotees are like fired up. So, of course, we will not do like that. We have an AC hall and we won't speak 3 hours. But at least we should hear, no? The point is not, tapasya is not the point. The point is, pastime sunna chahiye. So, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu came to Kovur. Because he was in Jagannath Puri and he had met Sarvam Bhattacharya, devotee. Sarvam Bhattacharya told, and then one day Lord Chaitanya told Sarvam Bhattacharya and all the devotees that I want to go to South India because my older brother Vishwaroop has taken sannyas and he has left home. I want to search for him. I don't know where he has gone. So I am searching for him. I want to search for him. Please give me blessings. So devotees gave blessings. Lord Chaitanya went to South India. So when he was leaving, Sarvam Bhattacharya told him that, my dear Lord, if you go near Vidyanagar, you will find one very exalted devotee of Krishna. His name is Ramananda Raya. He is the governor of Madras province. And he is a great devotee. But I did not realize he is devotee because I was an impersonalist, hard-hearted philosopher. So I used to think he is some sentimental fool. Now, because of your blessing, my dear Lord, I have become devotee. And now I have understood, that Ramananda Raya, whatever he was speaking, he is actually an exalted devotee. Now I am realizing that he is such a great devotee. So now, my dear Lord, if you go to Vidyanagar, South India, you should not miss him. You should spend time with him. You will really love it. You will really love to spend time with him. He is such a nice devotee. So Bhattacharya glorified Ramananda Raya. So Mahaprabhu heard and then Mahaprabhu continued. So then while in his journey, Lord Chaitanya came to Vidyanagar, the place called Kovur on the bank of Godavari. So when he saw Godavari, he remembered Yamuna. When he saw the forest of behind the bank of Godavari, he thought it is Vrindavan. He remembered Krishna, he started dancing, chanting. Then he took bath in the river Godavari and then he sat and he waited. This was afternoon time, he waited. And when he waited, suddenly a procession came with all band baja, South Indian band baja. Hundreds of Brahmanas were chanting Vedic mantras, Om Purushas, all Purusha Sukta mantras they were chanting. And it was intense. Brahmanas chanting and procession, band baja, and a lot of rituals. And Mahaprabhu realized some very big personality is coming. And that was the governor of Madras, Ramananda Raya, coming in a procession. He got down, he went to take bath. And Lord Chaitanya immediately understood, this must be the great Governor Ramananda Raya, who I was told about in Puri. Lord Chaitanya in mind, externally was sitting like this. He ran to embrace him, but he did not do it externally. He just sat. He kept control. Ramananda Raya, he went, he took bath and he came out. And he saw Lord Chaitanya. And he suddenly felt as if 1,000 suns have risen. Lord Chaitanya was so effulgent, so handsome, so attractive. So Ramananda Raya realized that this must be a very special person. Sannyasi robes also. So Ramananda Raya came very fast. He paid full dandavat. And when he offered dandavat, Lord Chaitanya told him, get up. Please chant Hare Krishna. Who are you? Are you Ramananda Raya? This is the question Lord Chaitanya asked. So Ramananda Raya could have said, yes, I am the governor of Madras province. But interesting reply Ramananda Raya gave. Are you Ramananda Raya? Lord Chaitanya asked. And Ramananda Raya immediately said, I am your lowly servant. Spontaneously. See, in this world, ordinary person wants lofty introduction. He wants very hi-fi introduction. But those who are really, really substance devotees, they want to be small. They don't want a big introduction. Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, when he heard him say that I am a lowly servant, Lord Chaitanya immediately got up from his seat. He embraced him. And this is one of the most intimate reunions of, see, Ramananda Raya's incarnation of one of very intimate associate of Radharani in the spiritual world, Vishakha Devi, Gopi. And Lord Chaitanya is the incarnation of Krishna, but even the mood of Srimati Radharani. So this is Radharani meeting Vishakha Devi first time in this pastime. So both of them, when they embraced each other, they felt so ecstatic that they fell unconscious there. And then they got up. And tears were coming from their eyes and they embraced. And when they embraced, Kaviraj Goswami describes, Eta sanyasira teja deki brahmasam shudra alingya kene korena krandan. Eta sanyasira teja, ye sanyasi ka tej to dekho. Who thought like that? All those hundreds of brahmanas were there. who had come in the procession, they were saying, look at this sannyasi. He also is a brahmana, sannyasi. And look at his tej. Aisa lagta hai ki sakshat brahman has come. But we are not understanding. How can he embrace this shudra? Ramananda Raya was from lower caste. He was from a lower caste. So these brahmanas were thinking, eta sannyasi rateja deki brahmasam shudra alingya kene korena krandan. And why is he crying so much? Embracing a shudra? Kuch samajh mein nahi aa raha hai. Ye sannyasi hai, brahman hai, aur ye shudra hai. During those days, caste consciousness tha pura samaj mein. So Lord Chaitanya realized, oh, everybody is watching, they are getting bewildered. What Lord Chaitanya did? See, Lord Chaitanya was so sensitive. Yei mata vipragan bhava more man vijatiya loke dekhi prabhu kaile samarpan. So this is an interesting verse. He says, Kaviraj Goswami says, Mahaprabhu realized, oh, all these vipragan, all these brahmanas, they cannot understand my heart. If they are brahmanas, but they cannot understand my heart. Yei mata vipragan bhava more man. So then Mahaprabhu said, oh, these are all vijatiya. Vijatiya loke dekhi prabhu kaile samarpan. Seeing the vijatiyas, vijatiya means what? Other jati. Sajati means own jati. Actually, Lord Chaitanya was born in Brahman caste. He's Hindu, Brahman, Sannyasi. All the Brahmanas are Brahmanas. So, logic, technically, they are all Sajati. Same Jati. But Lord Chaitanya considers them as Vijati. And Ramananda Raya, who is actually Shudra, lower caste, Lord Chaitanya considers him as same. Vijatiya loke dekhi prabhu kaile samarpan. Oh, I should not cry. Because Lord Chaitanya was crying. Ramananda Raya was crying. They were embracing. So Lord Chaitanya realized these people, they don't deserve to see this. You know, this intimate exchange. They should not see this. Lord Chaitanya control. Because, you know, there are a lot of sahajiyas in this world, in India, who imitate great souls. So great souls, what they do, they restrain their emotions. They don't show publicly. Srila Prabhupada also never showed publicly his emotions for Krishna. So they don't want to bewilder. So Chaitanya Mahaprabhu looked at Ramananda Raya. They sat. And Mahaprabhu told him, in Jagannath Puri, Sarvam Bhattacharya told me about you. That I should meet you. I am so fortunate today that I have actually got to meet you. And Ramananda Raya said, oh, Sarvam Bhattacharya told you. That means it is confirmed now that I am his servant. Because the fact that he spoke to you about me in my absence means that he remembered me. That means he cares for me. And that means he is my master. And by touching me, you have given me mercy. So now I have got mercy of Sarvam Bhattacharya. And now I have got mercy of you. And it is because of him, because of his prayers and blessings, that I have got your mercy. So like this, Ramananda Raya replies to Lord Chaitanya. See, look at his mood of devotion. This is a very exalted conversation. Ye jo aise aise words hain, this is very spontaneously coming from a heart that is steeped in humility and love for Krishna. Because Ramananda Raya is immediately connecting to Bhattacharya as his guru and Lord Chaitanya as God. Because Lord Chaitanya had told Rupa Goswami in Prayag, E Rupa, Brahmanda Brahmite Kona Bhagyavan Jeev, Guru Krishna Prasade Paye Bhakti Lata Bij. Krishna ki kripa se guru milte hain aur phir guru bhakti ka bij heart mein dalte hain aur usse phir Krishna milte hain. So Lord Chaitanya says, Guru Krishna Prasade Paye Bhakti Lata Bij. So now here Ramananda Raya is actually talking about that mood only. So we have no qualification. Ramananda Raya is such a great devotee that Sarvam Bhattacharya was a Mayavadi. He had misunderstood Ramananda Raya. He had not recognized him as devotee. But Ramananda Raya now considers Sarvam Bhattacharya as his guru. What humility.
जनरली आपने किसी को डेवोटी बनाया उसको आप बोलोगे ये तो मेरा, मैंने उसको डेवोटी बनाया, बट यू विल नॉट कंसिडर हिम एज दिस एज योर गुरु. एंड हियर वॉज अ नॉन डेवोटी हु वॉज हैविंग अ डिफरेंट फिलोसफी. बट रमानंद राय डजंट कंसिडर ही इज अ ग्रेट डिवोटी, हिमसेल्फ अ ग्रेट डिवोटी. Because Sarvam Bhattacharya said, he is a great devotee. Ramananda Raya is a great devotee. No, I am not a great devotee. He is accepting me. He is my master. Immediately clear. Mereko aisa Brahman nahi rehna ki I am great. This is a Vaishnava who always knows, I am not qualified. By blessings of others, I have got qualified. Prabhupada ko ek bar devotee ne pucha, Prabhupada, what was our qualification? How we became devotees and we got Krishna consciousness? Kya hua tha? Matlab, hum log kya past life ke devotee hai kya? Aisa matlab, kaise aaye hum log bhakti mein? Prabhupada said, you had no qualifications. I created your qualifications. So devotee meditates on this blessing. Because after millions of births, we get this association, which is this association which you have got now is very, very rare. So we can't waste this association. In Satya Yuga, people had to meditate for thousands and millions of years. In Treta Yuga, they had to do Yajna. Dwapar Yuga, they had to go to temple worship. In Kali Yuga, simply come together and chant Hare Krishna in an AC room. Bas. And the only thing we have to do is when the mind wanders while chanting Hare Krishna, we have to gently bring it back. That's all. Yato yato nishchalati manas chanchalam astiram. That's all. Itna simple process hai. Usme bhi humko itna problem. So Ramananda Raya is giving credit to whom? Sarvam Bhattacharya. Then he told Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, my dear Lord, I can understand that you are Supreme Personality of Godhead and I am a low caste person and you are also a sannyasi. You are interacting with householders for their purification. You don't need them. So to deliver me and my associates, you have come. And the proof that you are Lord is just look at them. He pointed to his associates. He said, you have miraculously transformed their hearts because they are all offering obeisances now to Lord Chaitanya. And Chaitanya Mahaprabhu immediately, what was his response? Immediately said, oh Ramananda Raya, I am a Mayavadi sannyasi. What you are glorifying me? In fact, Sarvam Bhattacharya knew that I am useless. So to help me, he told me I should come to you and learn about Krishna consciousness. So like this, they were praising each other. Chaitanya Mahaprabhu told him, that time he had to go for lunch to one Brahmana's house. So Lord Chaitanya told him, oh Ramananda Raya, I want to hear about Krishna from you. Sarvam Bhattacharya told me to hear Krishna Katha from you. So they decided to meet in the evening at that same spot. Now, Bhaktivedanta Thakur installed Lord Chaitanya's footprints there in that spot. So what we see in this pastime so far is an exchange where a devotee and Lord, they are both glorifying each other and not taking praise. If you see in entire Chaitanya Charitamrita, this is a consistent theme. Nobody accepts glorification for self. They only glorify the other. You know, every year after this drama festival you have, I get a lot of inspiration, not from the drama that you do. Drama to aapko achha rehta hai, professional. But what happens after that drama and during the drama inspires me a lot. Our Jaidas Prabhu, Jai Purna Prabhu, he appreciates everyone with so much natural, you know, I feel Chaitanya Charitamrita ke pages se bahar aa gaye log se. Everybody is appreciating others. Somebody is, even the props jo leke aata hai, karta hai, sabko appreciation karte hai Prabhu. So, in Hare Krishna movement, our ISKCON process is what, you know, where we always appreciate the others. Like if you see Chaitanya Mahaprabhu in Jagannath Puri, he is Supreme Lord, he is God. And devotees are coming to Jagannath Puri from Navadvip to see him. And what does he do? He is at Ataranala. He is welcoming them, putting garland on them and putting chandan on them and welcoming them as their servant. Actually, Radhana Swami Maharaj did that in 1998 Jagannath Puri Yatra. He came one day before for Yatra and he was at Ataranala. And when our devotees came in the bus, Maharaj was putting garlands on everyone and welcoming them, following that mood. So you'll see that this is a mode of Gaur Lila. Always glorifying the other person. Like when they would come from Navadvip for Ratyatra, Lord Chaitanya would see Advaita Acharya and say, oh Advaita Acharya, and they would embrace and then they would control themselves because both would feel intense emotions. They would want to cry, but they would check themselves. Then Lord Chaitanya would look at Shivas Thakur and his brothers, Shivas, Srinidhi, Sriram and Sripati, four brothers. He would say, Shivas, you four brothers have purchased me. I love you. So then Shivas Thakur immediately would say, no, we are useless. You would immediately take a back seat. And that house where Lord Chaitanya would meet all the devotees, that house would be so overcrowded. All devotees would want to see Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. But then Chaitanya Mahaprabhu would look at Advaita Acharya and say, today my life has become perfect. I am feeling so happy because you have come to Jagannath Puri. And Advaita Acharya would say, no, you are always, life is perfect, you are complete, but you are just encouraging us by saying that you are happy to see us. You don't need us. You have unlimited servants. Then, interesting, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu looked at Vasudev Dutt. Now, Vasudev Dutt, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu came to Puri with four servants, four associates. Nityananda, Jagadananda, Mukunda, Damodar, Chari Jane, Yukti Tabe, Korila Antar. So, these were four people. Nityananda Prabhu, Jagadananda Pandit, Mukunda Dutt and Damodar Pandit. So, Mukunda Dutt, one of them, his older brother was Vasudev Dutt. Now, Lord Chaitanya was very close friends with whom? Mukunda Dutt. Now, he has come with Mukunda Dutt already, but Vasudev Dutt is coming with all the group to Jagannath Puri. So, when Mahaprabhu sees Vasudev Dutt, now everybody is there. Mahaprabhu embraces Vasudev Dutt and says, Mukunda is my childhood friend, but I feel more happy when I see you rather than when I am with him. Now, Mukunda Dutt doesn't feel insecure. Are मेरे को साइड कर दिया. And Vasudev Dutt does not feel proud. कर देगा, I am more close. No. Immediately, when Mahaprabhu says that, you are older brother, he is my childhood friend, but I feel more happy seeing you. Immediately, Mukunda Dutt spontaneously says, Hari Bol, he becomes very happy. And Vasudev Dutt says, no, my dear Lord, he is more spiritual. He is actually taken shelter of you. Therefore, he has got your association since childhood. And he is actually my superior and he is my older brother. See, he is not an illusion. He doesn't believe the glorification as he is superior. Now, immediately after Vasudev Dutt, Mahaprabhu meets Shankar Pandit. Now, Shankar Pandit is the younger brother of Damodar Pandit. Now, Damodar Pandit is another close associate of Lord Chaitanya. I remember four people I mentioned. So, now Lord Chaitanya, now Mukunda Dutt was the younger of Mukunda Dutt. Was the younger brother of Vasudev Dutt. Here, Damodar Pandit is close to Mahaprabhu and he is the older brother. And Damodar Pandit is older, Shankar Pandit is younger. So now when Mahaprabhu sees Shankar Pandit, he embraces Shankar Pandit and he looks at Damodar Pandit and says, you know, Damodar, my affection for you is more like awe and reverence, because Damodar Pandit would sometimes scold also Lord Chaitanya. I don't have so much love for you. I am fearful of you actually. But I have more love for your brother. So, you should associate with your brother more. So that if you stay with him, then maybe one day I will also develop love for you. Because I love your brother. Everybody laughs when Lord Chaitanya says that. And Damodar Pandit immediately says, he doesn't get angry. He becomes very happy. He says, actually Shankar Pandit is my younger brother. But today, from today he has become my older brother. Because you love him more than you love me. So, I will now become his servant. So like this, if you see, everybody is appreciating the other person in Gaur Lila. It is completely opposite of material world. You know, like Shivananda Sen. Shivananda Sen was one personality in Gaur Lila. Big heart. All his money he would spend on devotees. Yatra sponsor. He would take all devotees from Bengal. 400 devotees, you take them from Bengal. They would walk for Rath Yatra to Puri. He would sponsor all the toll naka, the different, they had to pay toll tax. In fact, he would sometimes once took a dog also. Ek dog ko bhi unhone khyal rakha, raste mein. He would feed everyone, take care of everyone. So when Lord Chaitanya saw Shivananda Sen, Lord Chaitanya said, oh Shivananda Sen, you are the best. You are always serving devotees. And Shivananda Sen immediately said, my dear Lord, I am like a blade of grass that was tossed by the waves in the middle of the ocean for so many lifetimes. Now finally this blade of grass has found the shore. It has found shelter. And now my dear Lord, all your associates here, they are all my masters. I just want to serve them. I just want to please them. So like this, this is the mood. You know, all these devotees, Mahaprabhu was greeting. There were some devotees who were so special that they did not even come inside to meet Lord Chaitanya. They were feeling so unqualified. So bahar hi rehte the wo log. So Mahaprabhu would say, hey, where is Murari Gupta? Murari Gupta ka? Murari Gupta was Lord Chaitanya's very close friend. Navadvip. Mahaprabhu would do a lot of masti with him. He was older. Murari Gupta was older. So Lord Chaitanya said, where is Murari Gupta? So the devotee said, Murari Gupta is outside. So Lord Chaitanya said, call him inside. Murari Gupta, no, I'm okay. He would offer dandavat on the road outside. He said, I'm not qualified. So devotees went, come, Lord Chaitanya is calling you. And he began running away. So devotees had to run behind him, catch him and bring him to the Lord. And when he was brought, Murari Gupta is telling Lord Chaitanya, don't touch me. Don't, because he knows Lord Chaitanya will embrace. Lord Chaitanya had long arms. Nobody could escape his embrace. So Lord Chaitanya would just go embrace. Murari Gupta would say, no, don't touch me. I'm very sinful. I'm very low born. Mere paas mat aao aap. So Lord Chaitanya would embrace him and clean his body, because his body had become, you know, he had put all the sand was on his body. Lord Chaitanya cleaned. Then Lord Chaitanya met Acharya Ratna, Vidyanidhi, Gadadhar Pandit, Gangadas Pandit, Haridas Bhatta, Acharya Purandar. Pratyeke Sabhara Prabhu, Kari Guna Gaan. Puna Puna Alingya Korila Samman. Pratyeke Sabhara Prabhu. Every person Mahaprabhu met. And Kari Gunagan. Mahaprabhu appreciated every devotee he met. Puna Puna Alingya Korila Samman. He respected them by embracing them. And then Mahaprabhu said, one person, who is that one special person was missing? Any guesses? Haridas Thakur. Who all chanted most purely. Mahaprabhu said, where is Haridas Thakur? You know, Haridas Thakur was born in a Muslim family. And he was rejected by the Muslims because he used to chant Hare Krishna. And Hindus also rejected him, saying he is Muslim. But Lord Chaitanya knew that he is chanting 192 rounds every day. He is very pure. So Lord Chaitanya said, where is Haridas Thakur? Devotee said, please come Haridas. Lord Chaitanya wants to see you. Haridas said, I am an untouchable. No, I can't come. Haridas kahe Prabhu, na chuiya more. Haridas said, Mahaprabhu, don't touch me. Why? Haridas kahe Prabhu, na chuiya more. Mui niche asparsha parama pamare. I am niche asparsha. Asparsha means untouchable, fallen. And parama pamare. I am the horrible, most horrible person. Then Lord Chaitanya, when Haridas Thakur said, don't touch me, don't come near me, Lord Chaitanya's reply was very interesting. This is a classic reply, worth remembering for whole life. Mahaprabhu said, no, I want to touch you. Why? You may say you are fallen and dirty, but I want to touch you because Prabhu kahe tuma sparshi ami pavitra hoite tumara pavitra dharma naika amate. I want to touch you, Prabhu kahe tuma sparshi ami pavitra hoite. I will become pavitra if I touch you. Because tumara pavitra dharma, what pavitra dharma you have, naika amate. I don't have that. The taste for chanting which you have, Haridas, I don't have that. So I am going to touch you and embrace you for my purification. Because you are chanting Hare Krishna always, which means what you are doing is, Kshane kshane kara tumi sarvatirtha snan. Because you are chanting all the time, that means every moment you are taking bath in all the holy places. Kshane kshane kara tumi sarvatirtha snan. Kshane kshane kara tumi yagya tapa dan. So one who is chanting always is doing yagya, tapasya, dan, everything he is doing. Nirantara kara chari veda adhyayan. Advitiya nasi hoite parama pavan. You are the best of the sannyasis, Haridas Thakur. And you are the most purifying personality. You have studied all the four Vedas because you are chanting Hare Krishna. Aho batashva pachato gariyane jivagre vartate namatubhyam. Te pustapaste juhushashnuraya brahmanu churunama grananti ete. Bhagavatam says that even if there is a person who is eating dog, but if he takes up to chanting Hare Krishna, he becomes better than a huge, very, very big Brahmana who is doing Yajna, but who is not taking the holy name of the Lord. Because a person who is a dog eater but takes shelter of Krishna, he becomes freed of all sinful reactions and he starts actually developing love for Krishna. So then when Mahaprabhu was interacting with Haridas Thakur, Nityananda, Jagadananda, Damodar, Mukunda, Haridasa, Mili Sabe, Paila, Ananda, they all became extremely happy to see the interaction. It is interesting that, you know, Haridas Thakur is Muslim born, Lord Chaitanya is Brahmana, not only Hindu, Brahmana and Sannyasi. You are not supposed to come any, pura paradox hai, you can't come anywhere close to him, according to 500 years ago caste structure. A Muslim man and Brahman Sannyasi, and they are mixing together. And the best part was, Haridas Thakur was Muslim, fallen, he used to call himself, and never even attempted to enter Jagannath temple. Even today they aren't allowed. What Lord Chaitanya did? He did three special things which shows how Lord loves his devotee so much. Haridas Thakur could not go inside to see Jagannath. Jagannath came out every day as Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. Because Chaitanya Mahaprabhu is Lord Jagannath. So, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu would come every day outside to Haridas Thakur's place and give him Mahaprasad. So, person who is cannot go and see Jagannath, Jagannath comes to meet him every day and give him Prasad. This is the first most amazing thing in this Lord Chaitanya interaction with Haridas Thakur. Second, you know, we beg donations for Janmashtami, for festivals, for God. Arey Bhagwan ke liye donation do, mangte na hum log. But when Haridas Thakur died, when he left his body, when he left his world, Lord Chaitanya went to every shop and took donations, begged donations so that he could cook a big feast for glorifying Haridas Thakur. So we take donations for God and God goes and takes donations for Haridas Thakur. And then when Haridas Thakur was very old and very tired, Lord Chaitanya came to him. Lord Chaitanya said, Haridas Thakur, what is your disease? He says, I'm perfectly all right. My mind is disturbed. Actually, his mind was perfectly all right, but he was so humble. So Lord Chaitanya said, what is your problem? What is disease you have? He's very old. He's about to leave his body. He could have said, I'm dying. I'm leaving my body. He said, no, my disease is I'm not able to complete my rounds. How many rounds he was chanting? 192. And that was minimum. He was always chanting extra. So when he's saying, I'm not able to complete my rounds, means you're not able to chant his extra rounds. So Lord Chaitanya tells him, Arey, please reduce your rounds. Now, for all of us, Lord Chaitanya through his devotees is telling us to increase our rounds. But Haridas Thakur is the only special personality to, for whom Lord says, reduce your rounds. So these are the three things I find very fascinating about Chaitanya Mahaprabhu and Haridas Thakur. First, he is the only personality Lord Chaitanya says, reduce your japa. Second, Lord goes and takes donation for him. And third, we go to take darshan of Lord, but Lord comes to give darshan. So this is how Haridas Thakur is so special. So like this, there are many pastimes. See, then Mahaprabhu used to stay at Kashi Mishra's house. Jo unka ghar tha. Kashi Mishra was the superintendent of Jagannath temple. So every day there would be nice pastimes of Lord Chaitanya and all the devotees eating prasad. So sab description hai prasad mein item kya tha. कौन क्या सर्विंग करता था, कितना लाइन रहता था. चैतन्य चरितमृत इज सो मच ऑफ लाइफ, यू नो. वो जो प्रफादम सर्विस का जो इंचार्ज था, उसका भी नाम है वाणीनाथ मिश्र. वो हमेशा प्रफादम सर्विंग जब भी होगा ये रेडी रहेगा. ही इज लाइक, सो जब ये सब आए डिवोटीज, महाप्रभु ने गार्लैंड किया, सब हो गया फेस्टिवल, सब बैठ गए. फिर महाप्रभु का बड़ा फीस्ट था, जगन्नाथ का महाप्रसाद था. एंड शॉकिंग ऑफ ऑल बिग शॉक्स, सब बैठे प्रसाद के लिए और वाणीनाथ मिश्र ने सब सेटिंग किया था, प्रफादम लाइन, डब्बा, बकेट सब रेडी है. एंड व्हाट डू दे सी? चैतन्य महाप्रभु स्टार्टेड सर्विंग प्रसाद. डिवोटीज आर एम्बरेस्ड. और चैतन्य महाप्रभु अभी एक जो कैपेसिटी है खाने का, उसका तीन गुना ज्यादा सर्विंग करते थे. लॉर्ड चैतन्य वुड फीड एवरी पर्सन थ्री टाइम्स मोर देन व्हाट ही कुड ईट. सो डिवोटी आफ्टर सर्विंग नोबडी टुक प्रसाद, बिकॉज सर्व दामोदर गोस्वामी वेंट एंड टोल्ड लॉर्ड चैतन्य महाप्रभु, यू प्लीज स्टार्ट, बिफोर यू स्टार्ट नोबडी विल टेक प्रसाद. सो देन जस्ट टू प्लीज देम, लॉर्ड चैतन्य टुक प्रसाद. So like this, this is the way. So from Kovur we went to Puri. We'll come back to Kovur now, Vidyanagar. Remember, we are discussing which pastime now? Ramananda Raya. So in the lunch time they went. So now in the evening, after sunset, they met. Chaitanya Mahaprabhu looked at Ramananda Raya and said, Ramananda Raya, I want to hear from you. Please tell me from the scriptures, what is the ultimate goal of life? All of you listen to this question and answer. Very important. What did Mahaprabhu ask? Ultimate goal of life. Lord Chaitanya is asking Ramananda Raya. And what is Ramananda Raya's reply? He says, Varnashramacharat Purushena Parapuman Vishnur Aradhyate Pumsa Nanyata Toshakaranam. Everyone should be in Varnashram. You are a Grahastha. Do your Grahastha duty, Sannyasi, Brahmana, Kshatriya, all of you. Varnashram, offer all that you are doing to Lord and this is the way you can perfect your life. Good answer, no? Lord Chaitanya asked, what is the perfection of life? Ramananda Raya said, wherever you are in Varnashram, offer that. Now, Lord Chaitanya personally followed Varnashram perfectly. He was a sannyasi. He followed sannyas rules very perfectly. Khud follow kiya Varnashram. But ye discussion mein, Lord Chaitanya's answer to Ramananda Raya, when Ramananda Raya said this, Eyo Bhaya, this is Bhaya, external life. Eyo Bhaya, aage ka aar, say something higher. Isse aage kuch kao. Ye to external ho gaya. So then, what is the question he had asked? Ultimate goal of life, right? So now Ramananda Raya says, well, if this is external, then the ultimate goal of life is Yat karoshi yadashnashi yajjuoshi dadasiyat yat tapasyasi kaunteya tat kurushva madarpanam. From Bhagavad Gita he quotes where Krishna tells, whatever you do, yat karoshi, whatever you eat, yadashnashi, yat tapasyasi, whatever tapasya you do, everything you offer to me, Krishna is telling Arjuna. Kurushva madarpanam. This is the ultimate perfection of life. Good answer, no? Again. Excellent answer, actually. Pehla answer kya tha? Varnashram follow karo aur Bhagwan ko offer karo. To wo reject kya? Eyo Bhaya. So now he has said, offer everything to Krishna. Lord Chaitanya wanted to elevate the discussion. Lord Chaitanya wanted the conversation to go to the next level. Lord Chaitanya looked at Ramananda Raya and said, Rai, Eo Bhaya, Aage ka aar, kuch aur kaho, higher. So then Ramananda Raya quoted the most famous verse of the Gita, which we always quote. What is that? Sarva dharman parityajya mamekam sharanam vraja aham tvam sarva papebhyo Moksha Shami Masucha. Sab dharmon ko tyag do. Just surrender to me completely. I will protect you from all sinful reactions. Just surrender to Krishna. So Ramananda Raya thought, this is the answer to the which question? What is the ultimate perfection of life? And when Mahaprabhu heard this answer, what did Mahaprabhu say? Eo Bhaya. Aage kaho aar. This is all external. So then Ramananda Raya said, we should perform devotional service with knowledge. Brahma bhuta prasanna atma nasochati nakangshati samah sarveshu bhuteshu madbhaktim labate param. He quoted this verse where actually now Ramananda Raya is saying a person should practice devotional service. So, how many answers he gave? First and ultimate perfection of life? Varnashram. Mahaprabhu said external. Then? Offer everything to Krishna. Mahaprabhu said external. Then? Surrender to Krishna. External. And now he is saying devotional service with knowledge. And Mahaprabhu hears and says, Eyo Bhaya, this is external. Aage ko aar, say something higher. So now Ramananda Raya says, when Lord is saying, now you say something higher, then Ramananda Raya says a very beautiful verse from Bhagavatam. Jnane prayasamudapasya namanta eva jivanti sanmukharitam bhavadiya vartam sthane stita shrutigatam tanuvang manobhi ye prayasho jitajitop asite stri lokyam. The translation of this shloka is, Ramananda Raya is telling Lord Chaitanya, ultimate perfection of life is when we give up all speculative knowledge. Jnane prayasamudapasya namanta eva, just surrender to, just remember Krishna, offer prayers to him. And how? Jivanti sanmukharitam bhavadiya vartam. From our ears and tongue, we engage in glorifying Krishna. How? Sthane stita, wherever you are, you stay there. Shruti gatam, begin the process of hearing about Krishna. This is what is the main translation of the shloka. Sthane stita shruti gatam tanuvang manobhir. If you do this, ye prayasho, ye kari se kya hoga? Ajita jitopi, Krishna is ajita, unconquerable. Jitopi, he will be conquered. Ye prayasho jita jitop asite stri lokyan. So Ramananda Raya says, basically, wherever you are, stay there, hear about Krishna. Krishna will be conquered eventually. So when Mahaprabhu hears this answer, so first answer was what? Varnashram, reject. Second, offer everything to Krishna, reject. Third, surrender to Krishna, reject. Then, devotional service with knowledge, reject. Now, devotional service free of speculation and only beginning with hearing about Krishna. Lord Chaitanya immediately says, hey, oh, hi, this is right. This is all right. But Mahaprabhu says, aage kauar, say something higher. But this is very, very important. At this point, when Ramananda Raya says, hearing is the process, like what we are doing right now, Mahaprabhu approves, hey, oh, hi. And then Ramananda Raya says, Lalyam api ekalam mulyam. He quotes this beautiful verse where he explains when Mahaprabhu wants to hear higher, Ramananda Raya says, one should be greedy for Krishna. He says, if you are hungry, then you can appreciate food. Similarly, only if you are greedy for Krishna, then you can get love of Krishna. Not austerity, not penance. You should be willing to pay any price to get Krishna. So Mahaprabhu, when he hears this, he becomes very happy. He says, hey, oh, hi, this is great. This is all right. This is the perfect answer. Aage kauar. Say, tell me more. I want to hear more. And then Ramananda Raya gets more ecstatic. Oh, Mahaprabhu is approving. And Ramananda Raya says, ultimate, so the question is same. What is the ultimate perfection of life? So ultimate perfection of life, now he has said, is what? We have to have greed for Krishna. Now Ramananda Raya says, actually, the ultimate perfection of life is when we have spontaneous love for Krishna. Aisa pyar hona chahiye Krishna ke liye. Spontaneously. So Mahaprabhu becomes very happy. Hey, oh, hi. Aage kauar. Tell me more. Then Ramananda Raya says, actually, spontaneous love of Krishna is great, but that love should be in dasyaras. One should be in the mood of servant of Krishna. And Mahaprabhu is not able to control himself. He says, hey, oh, hi, please go on more. I want to hear more. Then Ramananda Raya says, actually from Shantaras, he has bought to Dasaras. Then at this point of time, there is a twist. Ramananda Raya says, Sakyaras. He talks about fraternity. He quotes this very beautiful verse in the Bhagavatam. Ittam satam brahma sukhanubhutya dasyam gatanam paradevatena maya shritanam naradarakena sakham vijaru krita punya punja. How Krishna's friends are playing with him. They were running in the pastures of Vrindavan. And the great Mayavadi, some people think that, oh, this is Brahman. Some people think he's an ordinary devta. People are speculating different things. But Krishna's friends are simply enjoying playing with him. This is a verse he quoted to explain how the ultimate perfection of life is to become a friend of Krishna. So till now, what was Mahaprabhu telling in response? Pehle kya bolte? Pehla kya bola tha? Eo bhaiya. Then Mahaprabhu said,
Ayo, hai. But when Mahaprabhu heard about friendship with Krishna, Mahaprabhu became very happy. He said, Ayo, uttam. This is the ultimate answer. This is the best answer you have given. Ayo, uttam. Very good, but aage kaho aur. You have to tell me more. You can't stop here. Then Ramananda Raya spoke about the Vatsalya Ras. How Nanda Maharaj, Yashoda, how they love Krishna as parents. And how Krishna steals butter and they catch Krishna. And Krishna denies that he has stolen butter. And then when they confront him, Krishna pleads guilty. So Ramananda Raya starts describing the pastimes of the Vatsalya Ras, where Krishna is a subordinate child of his parents. Gopyadade tvai krita gasidhamatavad yate dashashru kalilanjana samramaksham vaktram niniya bhaya bhavanaya stitasya samam vimohayati bhir apiyad bibheti. Kunti Devi is praying that Yashoda is running behind you, and as she is running and she is catching you, you have stolen butter and you are crying and you are breathing heavily, Krishna, and the black mascara from your eyes is got rub because of the tears and it is falling and you're breathing heavily. You are fearfully looking at Mother Yashoda. I am bewildered because fear is afraid of you and you are afraid of your mother. So this prayer Ramananda Raya is recalling, that how this is the ultimate perfection of life, to love Krishna like your own child. So when Mahaprabhu hears this, Mahaprabhu says, your statements, Ramananda Raya, they are getting better and better. Heyo Uttama, but I think very strongly that something more is yet to come. What is it? Tell me. So immediately Ramananda Raya says, the ultimate perfection of life, my dear Lord, is to love Krishna like the gopis of Vrindavan who loved Krishna in a conjugal rasa. In the mood of a lover. And this relationship is not available even in the Vaikuntha. Vikriditum vrajavadu biridam cha Vishnu shuddhanvitonu shrunuyadata varnayedya bhaktim param bhagavati pratilabhya kaman hridrogam ashu apahinoti achirena dhira. The highest perfection of life is to follow the footsteps of the gopis of Vrindavan. Whoever hears about their loving relationship with Krishna, that person's all dirty things from the heart will go away. This is the ultimate perfection. So till now, Mahaprabhu gave different responses to Ramananda Raya's answer. First, Mahaprabhu said, Ayo, bye. Then, Ayo, hai. And then, Ayo, uttama. But when Ramananda Raya said that the gopis, the ultimate perfection of life is to love Krishna like the gopis of Vrindavan love Krishna, Mahaprabhu said something very different. Mahaprabhu said, Eo sadhyavadi sunischaya. This is the ultimate limit of perfection. Then Mahaprabhu looked at Ramananda Raya and said, Aage kawar, tell me more. This is the ultimate limit of perfection, but tell me more. Then Ramananda Raya offered a comparative study of all the different rasas. He said, pure love of Krishna is in Shantaras. Means, like, you know, in Vrindavan, animals also love Krishna, birds also love, even the trees love Krishna. But they don't have intense emotional exchanges. That intensity in emotional exchange. It is there, but the expression is not there. That's why it is called Shantaras. But Shantaras is what? Pure love. Pure love hai Shantaras mein. But when pure love of Shantaras plus intimacy is added, that intimacy aa jata hai na. Ramananda Raya said, when that intimacy is added, it becomes Dasyaras. The servant who is serving the Lord, he has pure love like Shantaras, but now he is in the having intimacy also. Like he gives example of Raktaka, Patraka and Chitraka. These were three best servants of Krishna in Vrindavan. So Ramananda Raya says,
that in each rasa, different devotees are there and they are all fully satisfied. Koi problem nahi hai kisi ko. But each rasa gets progressively higher. And as the rasa gets higher, the higher rasa includes all the emotions of the previous rasa plus something more. So that's how he explains. He says, Shantaras is what? Pure love. Dasaras is Shantaras plus pure love plus intimacy. Then he says, when Dasya Ras is there, plus Dasya Ras means what? Pure love plus intimacy. When that is there, plus when you add confidence. Confidence in my relationship with Krishna. I am confident of my relationship with Krishna. What happens? And what is that rasa? Sakya, friendship with Krishna. Because Krishna's servants are intimate. Intimacy hai, but they are what? Awe and reverence. Krishna's servants are awe and reverence. Intimacy hai, but awe and reverence. But Krishna's friends are? Confident. Sridhama, you know, when Krishna goes and kills Chanura, Mushtika, sabse bade bade wrestlers ko maar deta hai Krishna. Sridhama say, ek minute, ye kaise mara isko? Ye gadbad hai, koi dusra to nahi aaya iske andar. So, Sridhama gets upset, he gets bewildered. Hey, apna Krishna hai na? Hey, wait, Krishna, wait. Let us wrestle. So, then they wrestle and Sridhama defeats Krishna. Then Sridhama is happy. Ah, apna hai Krishna. Theek hai, normal hai. So, this is the height of love in fraternity, in friendship, that they can understand that he is God. There is no awe and reverence. There is too much confidence. Like Krishna, like Brahma also got bewildered actually. When he saw Krishna is playing with his friends, eating curd. Curd rice in his left hand, he is eating with pickle and all that. Brahma also got bewildered. But Krishna's friends are playing with Krishna. In fact, Krishna right in front of them killed Bakasur. Bakasur ka pura jo beak hai, usko aisa phaad diya, maar dala usko. And all Krishna's friends are then wrestling with Krishna and defeating Krishna. And they are not able to connect. Arre, ye toh God honge na, isko mara. They're not able to connect. Itna love hai, that love, that sweetness of love eclipses the knowledge that of Krishna's strength. So because there is what element here? Confidence. Krishna hamara hai. Yadi duram gata Krishna vana shobekshanayatam aham purvam iti sanspriśya re mire. Sukadeva Goswami says, when Krishna sometimes goes in the forest to herd the cows or see something, so the friends say, Yadi duram gata Krishna vana shobekshana aham purvam, I'll run, I'll catch Krishna first. They all have a race. Who will touch Krishna first? So like that they have a race. So this is what rasa? Sakya rasa. Then Ramananda Raya is explaining, is answering Mahaprabhu's question on details of the rasa. So first he says is Shanta rasa, which is what? Pure love. When pure love has addition of intimacy, it becomes Dasya rasa. And then when you add confidence, it becomes Sakya rasa. And when you add to Sakya rasa, increased affection is added, it becomes Vatsalya, which Mother Yashoda had. All mothers worry about their child. Even in the class, you know, sometimes when we are giving class, child starts crying. Everybody gets irritated. But the mother, she may be irritated, but mother is really concerned. Mother has to take care of the child. She's like, mother's love is intense. And you can imagine what may be the love of mother of Krishna. In the material world, mother's love is so high for her child. What will be Yashoda's love? I remember once in Badrinath in 2011, in the evening time it would get very cold. Oh, asa 12-13 degree ho jata tha. So evening time after the yatra, we had a hall like this. We were 100 people in the yatra. Jagannath Priya's group, Prabhu's group, I had gone. So Maithili Rani Mataji was there. Our two sons were very young that time. So in the evening they did a drama, all the devotees, on that Sakshi Gopal drama. So her one son was Krishna in the drama. So they had put costume, mukut. Hota na, sab laga ke piche baitha khada tha. Uska scene last mein aata hai drama mein. To wo andar khada tha. To baki chal raha tha drama. Inka dialogue lamba chal raha tha. And we were all watching the drama. It was fun. But I told Jagannath Priya, in Rama side mein rakh, look at that Mataji, matlab mother of the boy, Maitli Rani Mataji, usko dekho. Usne dekha, I noticed her. She was not enjoying the drama. Because it was cold, her son was behind, wo shawl aur wo dhoti mein, flute leke, apna scene ke liye, wo mother ke haath mein bada blanket tha, and she's waiting. Kab drama khatam hoga? वो ब्लैंकेट लेके रेस्टलेसली ऐसा ऐसा चल रही है उधर और ये सीन इसको आ नहीं रहा है सभी एवरीबडी इज लाफिंग एट द जोक्स दैट इज हैपनिंग इन द ड्रामा बट शी वाज इन सो मच एंग्जाइटी फाइनली जब उसका और वो अंदर उधर ऐसा खड़ा है वो थोड़ा इट्स नॉट सो कोल्ड ऑल्सो बट इज मैनेजिंग यंग बॉय 9 साल का लड़का क्या कितना टॉलरेट करेगा कर रहा है और मदर देख रही है बट ड्रामा चल रहा है यू कांट गो एंड सो जैसे उसका सीन आया जैसे सीन खत्म हुआ वो Before we could start clapping, she ran to the stage and put that blanket on him and covered him completely. So this is vatsalya rasa, na? Anxiety, chinta. So in Vrindavan, Golok Vrindavan, Mother Yashoda is never peaceful. She's always in anxiety, stress. Oh, Krishna is going to forest today. Oh, the monkeys may scratch his body. Oh, the pebbles may hit him. You know, he may fall sick. The demons may attack. She's always worried about Krishna. So therefore, even when Krishna killed Putana, none of the gopis thought that Krishna killed Putana. Baby, they thought we are chanting mantras. So Lord Vishnu saved our child. And after Krishna killed Putana, they put all cow dung and all different things on Krishna's body to protect him. So Mother Yashoda's love is considered the highest. Nemam virincho na bhavo na shirap anga samshaya prafadam lebiro gopi. Etat prapya vimuktidat. That what Goddess Lakshmi could not get, what Brahmaji could not get, what Lord Shiva could not get, a simple gopi of Vrindavan got that. Nayam sukapo bhagavan dehinam gopika suta jnaninam chatma bhutanam yata bhakti tamamata. Ki what big jnanis cannot get, a simple woman Yashoda got. Evam sandarshito anga harina vritya vashyata स्ववशेनापि कृष्णेना यस्येदं शेश्वरं वशे कृष्णा डिड दिस डेलिबरेटली टू शो द वर्ल्ड दैट ऑल द देवताज आर अंडर माय कंट्रोल बट आई एम कंट्रोल्ड बाय यशोदा दिस इज सुखदेव गोस्वामीज वर्डिक्ट सो रमानंद राय कोट्स ऑल दिस वर्सेस टू लॉर्ड चैतन्य सेइंग दैट दिस इज वात्सल्य रस वेयर देयर इज एन एडिशनल एलिमेंट ऑफ इंक्रीज्ड नो इंटीमेसी तो था दास रस में आ गया इंटीमेसी इंक्रीज्ड अफेक्शन Pure love plus intimacy plus confidence plus increased affection is equal to vatsalya ras. Now when you add to this one more element, that makes it madhurya. What is that? Complete freedom. When there is complete freedom of expression, that is madhurya ras. So each rasa contains the previous rasa plus addition. So Ramananda Raya then gives a very beautiful example. You know, there are five sense perceptions we have, like sound, form, touch, smell, like that. And there are also five elements: bhumi, rapo, nalo, vayu, earth, water, fire, air, sky, ether. So he says a very interesting example. He says sky contains the element of what? Sound. Sound, you know, the Om, the creation hua, that was in sky, space. Sky contains the element of sound. Now, air. Next is air. Air contains sound plus touch. Touch. Right? And then, there is fire contains what first sound touch and also form so then Ramananda Raya says that water contains sound touch form and taste and then last is what is left of the five elements earth is left earth contains sound touch form taste and smell earth contains smell also. So similarly, he says, Shantaras is like what in this analogy? Sky. Sound is like pure love. That example, pure love. Then, after that, air. Air is compared to Dasyaras. And in air, there is, what is the additional element? Touch. So here it is intimacy. Sorry, बहुत टेक्निकल हो रहा है मैंने स्टार्टिंग में इसलिए कौन सा श्लोक अभी वापस भी लाए बोलेंगे सिद्धांत बोलिया चित्ते ना करो आलस यू रिपीट आफ्टर मी सिद्धांत बोलिया चित्ते ना करो आलस या होते कृष्ण लागे सुदृढ़ मानस ते कृष्ण लागे सुदृढ़ मानस क्लियर यस अर्थ वाटर फायर एयर ईथर So that's an example he gives to explain how Madhurya Ras is highest. Love for Krishna. In that Madhurya Ras, all the previous rasas are included. And then he says, Ye yatamam prapadyante tam sateva bhajam. As we approach Krishna, Krishna reciprocates. So those in Shantaras are perfect. But English language has limitation. In English language, we say perfect. Perfect actually means complete. But Shantaras is perfect. But the higher rasas are more perfect and most perfect. This is completely contrary. Arey, aaj bahut log khas rahe idhar. I hope it is because of mercy, karuna, not corona. I hope everybody is okay. Because of this coronavirus, itna panic fail gaya ki mera abhi next Saturday I was supposed to be in US. I had to cancel my US. Trip. I was supposed to be in West Indies. Sab cancel karna pada. Because, no, I was not afraid of the coronavirus. I wanted blessings of our devotees. Some of my seniors who are very important in my life, they told me, don't go. So to honor their wishes, I canceled. And because of that, I could read Chaitanya Charitamrita. So I'm grateful. But it is a lot of panic is going on. Or jab panic hota hai, that's why I decided not to go. Because then when you panic, there is more chance that the disease will spread faster. See, when you are alert, the disease doesn't spread. Right now, the fear of the disease is spreading faster than the disease. Abhi, hamare security wale Abhay Poirekar Prabhu bolte the, army mein bhi, defense mein kya hota hai? Security kaisa rehta hai? When you are protecting and defending from the enemy, You do it because you are alert. For the enemy is afraid of you. But if you are protecting out of fear, or enemy attack karega. Sab log satark raho, enemy attack karega, enemy attack karega. If you are fearful, then psychologically the enemy has a stronger edge. The enemy thinks, jaise malum hai, janwar ko malum padta hai. When I go, na, the dog comes to know that I am afraid. You will see, animals have a sense. So the enemy comes to know, psychologically comes to know that you are darpok. Afraid. So, enemy becomes stronger. So, right now in this whole planet, everybody is panicking. Coronavirus. So, virus is becoming stronger. So, we have to become alert. Alertness nahi, aisa panic chal raha hai. Isliye bola yaar, idhar hi rehte. So, it's not a good time to go. Anyway, so I spoke about this just because I wanted to little keep you awake. So, Shantaras is perfect. Dasaras is more perfect. Sakya Ras is most perfect. Vatsalya Ras is most perfect. Madhurya Ras is ultimate perfect. Actually, perfect mein sab kuch hai. But that is transcendental. And that's why, you know, Krishna tells the gopis in Bhagavatam, Na Parayam, that you renounced everything for me. So now, what can I give you in return? Your love for me is so high that I don't have anything to give you in return. So I request you, That you please be satisfied with your love. That is your reward. Because I have nothing to give you in exchange for your love. This is the way Krishna responds. So then Ramananda Raya, after saying all this, he says, In that association of gopis, which is the highest love, Krishna's beauty starts increasing. And when Krishna's beauty increases, the gopis' love for Krishna increases more. And seeing their more love, Krishna's beauty increases more. Like this, there is an intense competition between love and Krishna's beauty. And in material world, you know, beauty, what happens with time? It increases. In anywhere you have seen beauty increase in material world, it goes down, right? External beauty goes down, no? But in spiritual world, it's always in material world, it's like a tasty grape, dekha grape. Beauty is like grape turning into raisin. Or a flower, or a beautiful blossoming flower starts wilting away, becomes sticky. You see how it becomes, the flower? That's beauty in material world. But Vrindavan beauty is different. Krishna's beauty, sweetness starts increasing unlimitedly. At this point of time, after hearing all this, abhi ho gaya na, ultimate perfection ho gaya, sab khatam ho gaya. Lord Chaitanya hears all this and he starts crying. He says, Ramananda Raya, this is the limit of perfection. This is the ultimate limit of perfection, what you have told me. Now I beg you, please be merciful to me. If there is more, please reveal to me. Don't deceive me. Don't deprive me. Don't hide from me. Please tell me what is higher. Now you think there can be something higher than this? Ramananda Raya says, my dear Lord, no one in the world until this day has ever asked or heard anything higher than this. Gopi's love is the highest. Radha Kund is the highest place. And then Mahaprabhu says, no, Ramananda Raya, there is something higher. You are not telling me. You are deceiving me. Tell me. Then with great humility, Ramananda Raya is now going to tell Lord Chaitanya something higher than what he has spoken so far. Can you imagine there is something higher? Can you guess what it is? We will discuss this tomorrow. Abhi 8:30 ho gaya hai. Tomorrow we'll complete this. There is a lot of discussion, but we will, I'll do fast forward tomorrow. But it's very interesting discussion. There is something higher about Vrindavan only, about gopis only, about Krishna only, but it is something much sweeter, much higher, and much more beautiful. And this is a discussion which has never happened in the history before. So you like this discussion? So tomorrow you will have to come at what time? 5:30 if you are here. We will first sing tomorrow. Like today we sang Satyavrataashtakam. Tomorrow we will begin with Satyavrataashtakam, and tomorrow we will chant only one stanza, then we will read the translation and then chant second stanza like that, so that we can meditate on the meaning also. Is that okay? So today, whatever we have discussed, we can just take one question, not from Raj Parikshit Prabhu, but somebody else. And then we can, Raj Parikshit Prabhu should give answers. We should not ask questions. So any question anybody has, no problem. No, ye to achha hai. So thank you. Ramananda Raya ko itna question pucha Mahaprabhu ne. Aap log bahut merciful hai. Ek bhi question nahi pucha. Thank you. Because you are saying no. Aage ka aar prasad de do bas. Okay. Hare Krishna. But what we spoke in the beginning is very important. Two points. Holy name is essence of everything. And second, if you see Lord Chaitanya and Ramananda Raya's exchanges, it's all based on affection and love. At the end of the day, aapko kuch samajh mein nahi bhi aaya, chalega. If you can simply ensure that you have good friendship with each other and trust, respect and some kind words, to ye sab philosophy ek din chala jayega andar. If we don't have good relationship with devotees, if we don't have loving dealings, then ek philosophy kuch samajh mein nahi aayega. Pyar rahega to sab samajh mein aayega. Sometimes I've seen we are living in devotee community, but just because nobody is speaking kind words, we feel so disturbed. It's a fact, because you know, everything we look in terms of agenda, sir, transaction, all relationships are transaction. But Lord Chaitanya and Ramananda Raya, Jagannath Puri, all these devotees, examples we gave, all the relationships are not transactional. They are based on love. Do loves tasalli ke is shahar mein nahi milte hain. Do loves tasalli ke is shahar mein nahi milte hain kyunki log dil mein bhi dimag liye ghumte hain. No, this is true, no? ऑफिस में सब ऐसे ही है ना, सब एवरीथिंग इज कैलकुलेटेड, एवरीथिंग इज कैलकुलेटेड. सो लॉर्ड चैतन्य का पास टाइम्स में फिलोसफी समझ में आए नहीं आए, बट एटलीस्ट वी शुड अंडरस्टैंड व्हाट द लविंग जो एक्सचेंजेस है, जो प्यार वाला जो एक्सचेंजेस है ना, जैसे महाप्रभु का किस किस के साथ आज हमने पढ़ा एक्सचेंजेस, एक तो रामानंद राय के साथ और बाकी किस किस का, हरिदास ठाकुर, दामोदर पंडित, मुरारी गुप्ता, वासुदेव दत्त, सारंग भट्टाचार्य, मुकुंद दत्त, शंकर पंडित, हरिदास ठाकुर, शिवानंद सेन, शिवानंद सेन और कोई, यस. सो बेसिकली यू रिमेंबर, सो इफ यू रिमेंबर दिस एंड इफ वी ऑल्सो हैव सच काइंड ऑफ लविंग डीलिंग्स विद डिवोटीज, देन ये सब फिलोसफी अंदर चला जाएगा, नहीं तो कुछ फायदा नहीं है सब पढ़ के. ओके, सो आई होप टू सी यू टुमारो एट 5:30, प्लीज कम एंड वी विल कंप्लीट दिस पास टाइम, बिकॉज आपने आधा सुना है, पूरा सुनना जरूरी है, नहीं तो आधा यज्ञ हो गया आपका, पूरा कल आना ही पड़ेगा 5:30. हरे कृष्ण. How can we keep the dealing so personal like in Chaitanya Charitamrita? Correct. So you should become personal. So you, how? You become personal by becoming personal. See, your question is a typical how you do it question. In ISKCON, there are many questions called how you do it questions. How to become sincere? How to become simple? How to become personal? So the answer for this how you do it questions is, you do it by doing it. You become simple by becoming simple. You become humble by becoming humble. You become personal by becoming personal. तो किसी devotee को आप जानते हो, उसके birthday के दिन उसको wish करो, कभी उसको मिलते हो तो उसको पूछो उसका health के बारे में, किसी को एक gift दो, gift मतलब ऐसा घड़ी jacket वो नहीं, एक card, एक rose, एक महाप्रसाद, basically some loving exchanges. Having friendship, these things are the way you become personal, right? Like this. We'll stop here. Thank you very much. Hare Krishna. We'll have a short prasad, Mahaprasad prayer and then.